make the second coffee. After breakfast, before going out, if it's not raining, today is more cloudy, but actually this is the best weather when it's more cloudy. And I have to get the the water. Okay. Yeah, yesterday I also had another visitor in the late evening, I would say, even nighttime, you can say. But before midnight still. Actually 9 p.m. or something. And she came with her friend. This is the one that also bring me some food. Like this one, she was, I think, even buying for me, you know. This is delicious, but not good food, you know. That's not good food. I prefer the good food. Yeah, but now I have to eat it, you know. And she came because she wanted on this chair to, what is this, dye, color the hair of her friend, which seemed to be a male friend, but probably more like gay or whatever, you know. I cannot really say. To color the hair blonde. And then I asked, don't you like your black hair? I want blonde, you know. Why you want blonde like me? I give you my hair and, you know, you can have, I take your hair. No, I want blonde color. And I always say what I think, you know, so I say, you know, this is all chemical. Yeah, we know. They all know and they do it. You should not put this in your hair, you know, like this. And so on. But I had the opportunity. First, I did not want to let them in because I'm also sitting here in the dark normally. That I don't get the mosquitoes in also, and they are in, they are just here, one is flying around. And I don't want to open the gate when, you know, when it's dark. But because I knew her already, okay, then I let them in, because she don't have a place where she can do this with him. And I was wondering why. You have your place, you have his place, no, we cannot do it there. Some kind of secret or whatever they have there. We'll find out later, I think. But she is staying with her family as a 50-year-old woman. I guess she's around 50. That's strange, huh? But okay. And she is doing a lot of volunteer job or for very little money. You know, just from the good heart, doing the good deeds like the Muslim should actually do. You know, and but she is doing this for her Buddha. Now, but she is doing it against her as well, you know, by letting in the poison. And this is the problem. All your good deeds will vanish. First of all, the good deeds are usually also out of the programming, and that means out of the ego, because the ego is the programming. You must do this, you must do that to be a good, you know. Certainly also with a heart connection, but yeah. So when you then poison your body and you don't listen, cannot listen anymore. I was thinking this morning before I woke up, this woman actually wears the mask and the shield also inside here already 2 years. You know, this already brain damage and lung damage, and she told me also that her mother is already hospitalized with lung. She told the medical term, and I said, what is this? I don't know. Something that I didn't know, but I heard before already. you know, the problem with the lung. Yeah, and she asked me what to do. I say, vitamin. Go to the sun, vitamin D, eat fruit, vitamin. That's what you have to do, you know. Eat good food, rice, vegetable, and so on. Yeah, these are things they know already, you know. What else to do, you know. You already caused the problem over the many years to have the poison inside. That's why. And when you are then hospitalized, they give you more poison, the medicine. But I didn't tell her this because the friend was also talking on the phone and so on. And she then, when I talked, she talked then to her friend. They have no attention span anymore. It's going less and less. So they cannot hear you anymore. You know what I mean? It's really impossible. And she, I think she also wanted to take the opportunity to come inside here. Because before I always talk to her at the gate, and the gate is closed, probably just to see, you know, how I live and so on, but not to come alone, you know, dangerous man, you know. So because I'm talking also straightforward and very direct, and I wear no clothes, yeah, I'm naked, and I had to then also put on the light because they need to see what she need to see what she's doing, you know. And she asked also, maybe can also put on some light. Then, you know, her friend had also to accept, you know. But then I was sitting here on the sofa. So, yeah, they have to accept. And before she left, I said, oh, I forgot. Actually, my rule is everybody who's entering here must take off the clothes completely, you know, especially not to wear these things. Then I was looking under the wielder's mask. And I could see on the top of the mask, the normal medical mask that she was wearing, the light blue, all dirty, outside. I don't know how it's inside, because she wears the whole day. Also, when I roam around, and I use these masks actually to clean the parking machines, you know, on the top and everything. Or when it's raining, then it's also on the side, have mud dust. I clean it up wherever I come along such a machine. Then I see, you know, the mask. Sometimes they are clean and sometimes they are really dirty, you know. I think you know what I'm talking about. It's unbelievable, you know, what the people put in their face the whole time. And of course, the main thing is they believe in a virus, you know, that there is something dangerous. You can tell them whatever. There is no virus. Prove it to yourself. Find out the virus. They believe in science. This is the religion. The scientists say, the experts say. And that's why, you know, you have to believe. In the middle of the word, believe is the lie. Oh no, this is only coincident, you know. No. Sir Francis Bacon did this on purpose. This is all on purpose. When you research this, the work from Kieron Last, The Golden Web, you will find it's all in the words. The programming is in the words, and the sublineal, I think, programming into the unconscious is there. When you say love, you mean evil always. And most important, the illusion. Yeah. God bless you means Satan bless you. Because if you look at this, who can be the God? If you realize something, then you will know. And the people are using this, you know, because automatism, and these people will all go to their destiny. Yes, this is for sure. And I also have to work things out, like the word I just used again, you know, because we have it in, but there is no I, only the ego, you know. Yeah, let's continue with the topic here of Arthur's insights that are streaming out every day on Facebook, but now they are blocked until February, and they're this is also a good thing. Everything, every measurement you have to see as a good thing, because actually Facebook is telling ArtHUR, take care yourself or your family now, because you have to now move to another place and you cannot spend your time on Facebook all the time. Yeah? Get out of here and do something. You have more and more things to do now, as it's getting more and more tighter for those who are unwilling to be vexed. So it's actually also time to leave the internet, but he still is thinking, you know, there might be somebody and I can also address this. Maybe you should look at how many people you could count on that you would say, not for your idea, you know, to make the kingdom, but that they would do it themselves. There are certainly a number, and this can be go also into the thousands. But when you check out these people, you make a test with them, you will see they all fail, included this man. Yeah. And when we test ArtHUR, like when I test ArtHUR, he would also fail in certain things. You know what I mean? Because, you know, I can point out the thing, laugh, and he would say, yes, I agree to you, with you as okay, but he's continuing this. And when you continue this, you know, you're in the loop. So, he talks about voices in your head. That's a topic. It's the voices in your head that you hear all the time. What are these voices in your head? ArtHUR CrisTIAN, Love for Life, 27th December 2018. Listen to this well, because this is as deep as you can go about this thing. You know, you would never think these are voices in your head, but when you think about it, you hear voices in your head. And when you hear voices in your head, and you might write this also here, you're in mental asylum. Yeah. And he will tell you what these voices are, where they come from. The system is the process of allowing someone else inside your head to define the fake persona. This is what how he defines the system. Processing, forecasting. Sounds also like chess a little bit, because it's C. The C in check with this sign would be then chess. So it's not wrong to assume that it's actually related to chess. For chess, or pro has also another Latin meaning that Chiron points out in the Golden Web part 3, but I forgot it already. I don't get it in. Allowing all low. Allow means all low. Someone, one is the dead number. Someone else, L certain. Can you believe this? Inside your head. Yeah? Like I did yesterday with this woman. And she might change her mind because she realized, fuck, I got somebody in my head. He actually got everything that he wanted, but only because I also made an acceptable offer. You know? But this is what I made my head around, and this I got through. You know? And she could not get what she wanted to have. You know? Like, you just give me the money now, and from last month also, and then maybe, because she also said, I will talk to the one that can make it, you know, to fix the roof. She wanted to do it her own way, you know, not the way that I tell her. This is on one hand correct, but on the other hand, it will not be the way it should be then, you know what I mean? And that's why I made it clear, but to these people, vaccinated people, I don't think you can make anything clear with them. Tomorrow they forget. This was already with the Mali before, like this already. They easy forget. I only start to pay the installment when this roof is on top. When the roof is the same like the other roofs. Yeah. And I told her this cost 4,000. And so she has to make the investment, and I pay back every month 400. And this is the rental price. From all the places, they pay 400. In what about pay more? Can you pay more? I want 500, you know, like the guest house manager, operator. No, 400 is the maximum. And that tells her then, I should look for somebody who give 500. But also the woman yesterday, she said she won't find anybody. This is a broken place. When you look at the floor, you know, I just removed also some other plastic cover from the wooden tile floor. You know, this is not really wood. This is compressed, you know, cardboard. Or I don't know how they do this in the factory. And it's still wet also. You can still see the dark color, and not normally this light brown. Yeah, now it looks more like dark brown. Okay, so she won't find anybody, don't worry. But still, I'm not a customer, because they see you as a customer, of course, yeah, money, that it's not a pleasure with this customer, you know what I mean? He's talking around your head. And this is really a black magic method. That's why I got everything that I wanted, because she wanted to have something when she heard that I actually will pay her back this investment. Yeah, then it's okay, you know. Then she realized this is something we can start with. And what about later? The next condition, you know, this unconditional love, unconditional illusion. And then I said, yeah, this is the thing. When you do this, you become like my friend, because you solve my problem actually that I have, and then we can continue on this basis, because I pay you every month the 400. In 10 months it's paid off, the whole amount that you invested. It doesn't matter what the amount is, and then we continue on this basis, but it will be a 400 installment and not more, because if I do more, they want then this amount to continue, you know. And I'm willing to pay 400, not 300 or something. Could be also, because when she gets this roof for 3,000, it was offered to me 4,000, but I'm the foreigner, you know. So she can actually get it cheaper. And, you know, then I could say, okay, then I pay 300 installments. But I think, okay, continue like this. And I also know the situation on the other side. I will not accept the line. I will not pay rent. I said to her, I will give you, I will not pay. This is also important that you don't pay anything. I will give you a donation. Yeah? Because I know your situation, even though I don't know the situation, but I know that you need money. And she also told me that now the prices go up for everything, also for the hair coloring. Yeah, my friend, the hair coloring is not important, you know. They can make it $1,000 so that you don't buy the shit anymore, you know. And the mask should be also one mask $10, not even enough, $100, so that they don't wear it anymore, you know. Then they better pay the fine, you know, or learn from me how to avoid paying a fine, even you are using the person. That's all possible, yeah. But yeah, forget about it, you know. And also she said to me yesterday, these people here will never accept you. Actually everywhere, they will not accept you. You are always the foreigner, you are always the stranger. You can color your hair black and make also dark eyes and make a dark skin, which can be done when I'm every day out in the sun. They will never accept you. They will never like you. They will always hate you. That's what she didn't say, but that's what it means. Yeah? And it is really like this. Yeah? They cannot deal with this. And the main reason I say is the darkness cannot understand the light. It's not possible. And she's actually doing this also out of the darkness, because of programming. She was educated to be like this, you know. So I could never visit her in her place. They would not accept this, her family. She cannot even bring her friend, which is a, I don't know what this is. I would say Malay, but somebody who's not really accepted by the society, because different, you know, and so on. These are hypocrites. Ah, forget about it. So, yeah, so the fake persona. This is the thing. That's why I'm talking also about the real example in my life, so to speak. Because you can see this, the fake persona. That is the name. The fake persona is the name. And you really need to actually copy this in and comprehend, of course. And of course also check if this is true or if there's something else or where's the lie. You always have to ask, where's the lie in this? What is being presented? And the more you learn, the more knowledge you have, the more you will realize where's the lie. Yeah, I can point out with other things that are blind spots. Doesn't mean his intent is to lie. But there's something that must be really presented in a better way, which at that time I could not see, you know. I hardly could make a comment because there's nothing else to say, you know. But now I could say far more, but this is more really drilling into the detail. And this can be also, of course, also seen by the fake persona that Arthur also possesses or is possessed by this. That he just want to, you know, you only want to find mistake, psycho attitude also, to make me look bad. But this is actually not the case, you know. You can also do this to improve something and say, look, look at this. There is still a problem. Can you see this? Step out of this fake persona and see it as an outsider, you know. Okay, so the fake persona is the name of the vessel, body. Yeah, your body has a name, but you are supposed to be undefined. This not even man, not even man is. Yeah, you can call the body man, but man is also a word, and has also a relation to the moon, to the illusion. That means it's still deluded. Yeah. You continue to default to the name. You always default to the name. You really need to practice not defaulting to the name anymore, really, and then getting ready to remove the documents by just not using them anymore. No need to tell anybody, or I want to announce to the government and so on. The government does not exist. There's nothing to do, you know what I mean? You have only the problem with these idiots. They're representatives of this, you know? Representatives, not even presenting anything. Just representing or representing, and rely on this name, and also because you never learned anything else, Ray lie, the lie from Ray, Amon Ra, onto life, and rely on to live your fake life out of your. You live your fake life out of this name. The name is the basis. That's why he made the video. The name is the mark of the beast. Chiron sees the mark of the beast actually as the moon. And when you see that the name is attached to the body, to the man, you can say, there is the moon. So both are correct, but in a different way describing it. And Arthur is doing this more attached to reality, while Chiron is going into the fantasy world of the words that reveal all these things. Because you have never created an undefined soul, man. He says the undefined soul is man, so it's beyond the body actually. And soul is sol, sun, star. The sun is also called a star, even though it might not really be a star, but you know, in these models at least. And that means light, starlight. Yeah? So you don't have the light, or you're disconnected from the light at least, you know what I mean, because of what is coming now. That is the glorious lighthouse of your unique original dreams that you created long, long time ago, so to speak, more than 6,000 years ago. You created this. You are the creator, you know? Or are you not creating anything? Now only dead things. But you have created the living before. Who else? Can Can you bring forward someone else? That's what art is saying. You know, no outside entities or something. Chiron is there a little bit different. He also sees, you know, the power of the stars. But when the power of the stars is us, and also what we refer as them, it is correct when you say this is the grace from the Sirius constellation. Yeah? And Sirius is probably the brightest star beside the Polaris, I don't know. So, but not as bright as many all the other stars together, no? That's why making the division, so that every star is single, singularity, you know? That is far stronger than all the voices of others, strangers or not, inside your head, so to speak. So this is the thing. You have not created an undefined soul, because since you appeared in the womb, you had these voices that entered your head in the womb already from your parents and others, and you know, city noise and whatever, all the distractions that are destruction, and then you can never create your soul. You come with certainly with life force energy, the power that is this light, but you lose the connection. That's why we are also going to die in the body, or the body dies, cannot sustain. The life force energy is drained out. Yeah? With every beating of the child already, and with every fear porn that is also now happening, you know, that's why the people are dying now also. And this, the health, so to speak, will go down rapidly, you know, because, you know, the chaos is now unfolding, the chaos that was already in the head. Yeah. When you have this lighthouse on, which they will never allow you to do, you have to really cover this. You have to make it also undercover somehow. And they still see it, but their lackeys cannot see it, because the lackeys hate this, that you have a light on, you know. When you really have the light on, all the people will hate you all around you. Even they still smile or whatever, they will work against you. That shows you have the light on, but you have to be more and more careful to keep your light on, because, you know, physically they can, you know, do like what they did with me 3 months ago. And you will really feel it drains out your life force energy until death, you know. Also after this, you know, I was very fit at that time, and I didn't gain back the fitness after 3 months, you know. And actually now it's even more difficult, because before I was more free to do things. I could do exercise outside here in the park in the nighttime before 3 a.m., you know. These are things, they are gone, you know. I have to do things here inside. You know, outside I cannot do this. They can come anytime. I cannot go out in nighttime also. Even though I knew before that it is dangerous, you know. The night is for the gangster. They are controlling the city, you know. In daytime, the big mafia gangster, you know, politicians and so on, with their lackeys, police and soldier, and in nighttime they are going to sleep, and they let the gangsters doing this, you know, like this. That's why they are not being arrested. So this is what I say also, because Arthur, he always says you have to let your light shine into the darkness, and the best is like a sun. You can see it now, yeah? Where there is light, there cannot be darkness, but the stars work different. They have only their light in their corona, in their circle, and they cannot shine out bright. It's only the sun can do this. Probably because the sun is at the firmament. That's why it can shine onto the earth surface, onto the screen, so to speak. Yeah, the screen of the cinema, movie screen, like this. I see it this way, you know. Yeah. So you are not really the sun. You know what I mean? You are just a star that is the way you see it also in the sky. The sun is the brightest light, but a little bit in a different thing than the stars. The sun more connected with the planets that are also wandering stars, but they wander along with the sun and with the moon. This is this constellation, but the stars, our ancestors actually, they move another way, you know, as you can see when you look at time lapses and so on. Yeah. So, and this is what you realize then, voices of others, strangers or not, inside your head. So it's not just, you know, that people come to you and try to brainwash you, you know, influence you, and this certainly works. Yeah, I cannot say that this woman has no influence on me. She also pushed something in this direction that I have to come out with this, because if I would be really, I'm not worried and there's no ownership, and I just push on to this ownership thing, that she has no chance with this lie, and without ownership claim, you cannot, what do you want here? What do you want from me, you know? Yeah, this is my place, you cannot prove that this is your place. I'm here, so this is my place. And then we have war, because these people cannot get their head around, and even you explain to them in all detail, they don't want to know these things. They actually say, I know, but continue, you know, this is the way we do things. We love to do this because we are the evil ones. This is the answer. Then you have this outcome, and this outcome will be certainly the destruction of the body. With force, they will get you out. This is very clear. And you can say whatever you want to say, they will not listen to you. They are very good in ignoring you, and this is also what Arthur is writing. And that's why you have to make somehow a deal, unless you really don't need this, you know, and you think, okay, like she said yesterday also, maybe you should go back to Thailand. I say, yeah, it's very difficult now to cross the border. She say, we know a way how to get you over there. I say, it's not only getting over there, you know, there's police and soldier, roadblocks, everything. And the people themselves, they see me, they call. Here's somebody walking around, can you check this guy? You know? And then they check, no documents, where do you come from? And with the Thai authority, it's different. You cannot make any discussion, you know? They will not listen to you. And here also sometimes, but usually, you know, I could deal with the police. This was no problem. And I think even, not comparison to all the police in every country, but I think in this case, my encounters with the police was the best you can ever have. You know what I mean? And not only because I was the way I talked to them or something, it was also because of the attitude, they are just too lazy to do anything. And if they are not have an order to do this, then there's nothing to do, you know what I mean? It's like this. But in Thailand, it's more strict. You cannot make any discussion. And then they put you into the situation. You have to actually humble yourself, of course, you know, and they say, stop, you cannot talk anymore. Then you don't talk. And then you sign this now. I cannot sign. Then they beat you until you sign, you know? They put you, you know, into the cell and you stay there. Can also do without food and water until you sign. And they have no problem with this. And when you have signed, you have accepted everything. And what they did to you, it didn't happen. He just made it up. You don't need to complain about it. So you have to go through a very hard time that can also cause you physical death. Like they did with some Sudanese long time ago. They imprisoned them. Next day they were dead in the prison cell because they realized, fuck, we cannot get out of here. We are dying here. Whatever they want to do with our bodies, we are dying here. And they managed to get out of their bodies. Can you believe this? This is how they left the prison. This is amazing. That means these people, it's a long time ago, I think 100 years ago, they were still connected and they were able to leave the body. And I see this also with animals, you know. When they are kind of sick on something and I try to help them and treat them, they just say, let me go. And then they actually run away even so that they have their peace and can leave the body. And this probably is a process of a day or something. And the final process is 30 minutes struggling because they have to extract their soul out of the body, and they are able to do this. Can you believe this? So, but you cannot do this because you have this, the voices in your head, they keep you in there so that you experience all the evil demons from the others. You know what I mean? Yeah. You have allowed, although, others to define you. Emotions and all. And this is all fake. So this is the claims, you know, when somebody makes claims about you, is impersonating you. And also the same for me, you know, when I talk about, now I talk about Arthur, that's already also, you know, claims and also impersonating, like, you know, I know Arthur very well or something, while I actually know next to nothing, you know. So you have to see it also this way, to be critical with this. Yeah, the definitions of others become the motor that drives the vessel of your now fake life. They define you. They define you as a lunatic. Then you will run around like a lunatic, you know, because you have the label lunatic, and it's not only seen outside, the mark on the forehead, you see it also in the inside. Oh, I'm a lunatic, because you see how they see you, you know. The wind in the sails. The reason d'être, this is French, d'être, of the fake persona. Mm-hmm. The ego. Witch. When I say witch, I pronounce the witch. Nothing else. This is what you hear also, but you're thinking about the usual witch. It is witch. You call out a witch, a witchcraft, the black magician. That's why I actually must stop talking, really. This is really black magic, which is now who you, or you pronounce it different. You say witch, witch. It's still a similarity, but you can, you know, foreigner, non-native speaker, then witch, Filipino would also speak like this, then it is already softened, you know, then it's not a black magic thing so much. Witch is now who you believe you are. Because I am Arthur, you know, this is my name, this is Arthur, and this is also my name. I made up the name, yes, you know, completely lost. You believe you are, lie inside the word believe. But these definitions have no strength in them. Definitions themselves have no power. You empower this with your life force energy. And so their influence ebbs, flows and fades very fast when you don't energize it, you know, and you don't call out the name anymore. You know? And when somebody asked, what's your name? She also asked me yesterday, what's your name? I say, this man has no name. I always have to answer like a robot as well. What? No name? How should I call you? I say, you never call anybody. This is calling a dog. Always. How I can address you? She tried to use other words, you know? Then I would say, address is also fake, you know? There is no address. You just come and I see you with my eyes. And then I see you want something. And then, because you want something from the system, you know, so you have to use words, and then I show you what the words really mean. And actually we cannot get to the point, you know. And they also do like this, and yeah, now get to the point. 500, no? We want from you. Yeah. The gangster. Even old, you know? But this is gangster. That means, you know, the leader is of the gang can be also an old man or something, you know? The mafia boss. Yeah. So, if you don't energize it, then it ebbs away, but the other demons, the demons in the other's head, they will continue like this. Yeah, they will always test you and always ask for your name and so on. So you cannot play the game with the police only, and with the other people you say the name that was given to you or a nickname. You know, how should I call you? How did they call you? Don't they know your name? Oh, I say they knew but already forgot, and the manager called me Thomas the last time. I think before he called me another name. Because they want to call names. They cannot do otherwise, you know. And whatever. I never was called Thomas, but okay. He sees me and he looks like a Thomas, you know. So then he can say Thomas. And she says, oh, then I call you Thomas. But I say, that's not me. You're not calling me when you say Thomas. He's doing this and this is up to him. This is the mental asylum, you know. And then I'm even reacting. Because when he would call me, Thomas, Thomas, then I'm reacting because I know he means me with Thomas. You know what I mean? You don't call. You go to the one and you go around and have the direct contact. Yeah? And then you can talk. That's it. If you want to talk. Otherwise you just walk your way. Always returning to immense weakness, causing you to drift from one moment of a defined lifestyle to the next. Unlike the lighthouse of your soul, that is the undefined dream that never wavers in strength, intensity, and focus, no matter what is thrown at it, voices and all. Yeah. There's at least a theory about this. I don't think anybody has this because you can see also with others' reaction. The source or the star is certainly there with the strength, but when you're disconnected, you don't receive anything. You know what I mean? And whatever they throw at you, and when they physically damage you, you will see how this energy that is still connected to you to keep your body alive will fade away. You can beat somebody to death. You know what I mean? This is how the soul is also extracted. This is another way. So, of course, when you are trained in this like me now, when the voices come, the black magic and all the lies, you cannot accept them. They cannot even speak a sentence because in the sentence are already so many words that is all wrong, you know. So, politely, you have to let them talk, and then you go into these details, and then they think, why is he going into the details? You know, can you not get the whole message? And then I explain to this, because I know what they are thinking, that the whole message is already a lie, and I have to show you now what is the lie. We have to sort out the lie. This man will not accept the lie. And this is what they have to accept, but they don't see that this is a lie. Or they don't want to accept that this is a lie, because actually they say, when I explain to them, I know, but we all do like this, you know, that's why you are going to die, that's why. And is eternally enduring, more powerful than anything else, and can never be brought down. Yes, but in connection with your body, you know what I mean? This is the thing. This, with your body, it can be done. Because the body is actually also dark matter, I would say, in connection with light, but, you know, know, the body will be laid to rest. Soil, this is dark matter. The earth, you know, and it is empowered. What you see on the surface of earth, the nature, is empowered through the light. Yeah, and you learn this also in biology and whatever. Biological, chemical process, however this is called, physical. It is about this. Actually the four elements, yeah? Okay. In the system of this mind control, everything of the system returns to nothing. Because it was nothing when it was first thought of. That's now. It's happening now. It's a system of mind control, of course. Mind control means government, you know. Everything of the system, ray turns, this is Saturn. The word ray turn means Saturn, you know? Because Saturn is say turn, you know? Turn is inside. And ray is Ra, Amun Ra, that means Saturn. You know? Returns to nothing. We will go now to the nothing. From the singularity, the next step is the nothing. Yeah, we are going now into the singularity, and then you become nothing, because from the one you have to become zero, the nothing. Because it was nothing in the beginning. In the beginning was the blub, you know? There's nothing there. There's something, this is the earth, you know what I mean? No matter how it is made up, you know, with the projectors, you know, the stars at least. And now also with the influence of the planets, the wandering stars, or in the religious term, the angels, yeah, the days of the week, you can also call it like this. These are the main powers, and they have certainly with the moon also the influence, moon illusion, to create these things in the head. That this is actually also the programming, that this is where it's coming from. This is also what is being worshipped. And it's not really the idea of, not directly the idea of man. It's under the influence of the moon. Moonstrual cycle. Cycle. Maybe you have to see it this way. That's why the works of ArtHUR and the works of Chiron, you have to probably put it together, you know? And then I think you can see then the bigger picture. It's the nothing. That's why it's a big mistake when you see yourself as the nothing, because then you go into the nothing. You know? You are something. You are of substance. And it needs the dark matter and the light matter together to form this together. The light alone is just the light. Nothing to do. The projection here on earth is only possible because of the dark matter of the earth. And also, what I learned yesterday also at the beginning of the work that is called Ether, in Chiron last channel, Ether, because you have to think for yourself more according to the flat earth model. But even in the solar system, you know, they're moving around in the dark matter. And this is what you can see also, how they move around, but in lanes somehow, you know. It's actually always the same lane. How is this possible? And this is called ether. Yeah. Even though it is nowadays not used anymore, but it is a substance that they move in. They're embedded in there. And this is something that the ether here, what we call atmosphere or stratosphere. Stratosphere. Stratos is, by the way, the army, I think, so well I know. The force, the army, the fear force, that the sunlight can shine through. Something that can shine through, but also the light can be embedded in the ether. This is how you have to see it somehow, yeah? But the way I explain it is only close to the truth, it's not the truth, really. Because Nikola Tesla could also not really, and also not Einstein, who actually then also said something like this. But was not heard anymore by the herd, by the sheeple herd of scientists, you know. They were already too much into the relativity bullshit. Mm-hmm. It is dead system, yeah? It's dead, soulless. Because these definitions are pure fantasy. What is often ray ferrum, ferrum, the iron, then this is the ray, the Lucifer ray, yeah? To as darkness or shadows. These are the shadow powers. Shadow powers in the head. Demons, you can also call it. Why not write it demons? You know, that's also good to add it on. So this is not from Arthur then. You see? And when you get to this, somebody who is the closest to the truth, and you will not find anybody closer, except for the another way, this is Chiron, but nobody else is coming even close to this. And when you find then something, even just this add-on, that's already something good. You know what I mean? Then you're already quite good in this. Because you also comprehend then something. If this is correct, yeah? Again, it is dead, soulless, because these definitions are pure fantasy. What is often referred to as darkness, or shadows, or demons. The darkness in your head. This fantasy is darkness. Even you paint it in all kind of colors, you know. These are shadows, shadow powers, and these shadow powers, ghosts, demons. The thought forms, because they create the pictures in your eyes. That's what you then see, you know. When you see then somebody, oh, he have no shirt and he wear the helmet and he's, oh my god, crazy, you know. Oh, they beat him up, I think he's that guy anyway, and crazy, just remove this guy, it's good, you know. Oh, he's bloody, doesn't matter, you know, he deserves this, you know. Yeah. This is how evil works. It's all coming from these shadow powers that is actually the nothing, dead, soulless. This is the interesting thing, this is the paradox also about this, that the nothing can rule over the something. Because the nothing is empowered with the something. You see, every human has this power, this life force energy, and can empower also the fantasy. This is how it happened. And they cannot redraw the energy. You have to redraw the energy for the fantasy. Yeah? Stop fantasizing. And this is very hard to do with the voices in your head. Next to impossible to do. Only with the breathing meditation you can get out of it for a very little time, so to speak, for a few moments. All voices inside your head are pure fantasy, and if you let these voices harvest your life energy, your labor, they certainly suck the life energy, because thoughts need a lot of energy. You will always end up with nothing real there. The real, this is your soul, you know? Because real means existent alive. You may accumulate so-called system wealth in terms of possessions, comforts, privileges, and exclusivity, but this is all fantasy too. Because what is the wealth? The money. That's all fantasy, you know? It doesn't exist either. So you still have nothing. You got nothing. You die with nothing as nothing, and you will go into the nothing. Probably you came from the nothing as well. All the voices from the absolute confusion and distractions of your fake soulless life. You see, and you can see this personal, but when you read it like this, because he's not addressing any personal name, you can see this with a little distance, you know what I mean? Even though it's directly to you, you know? Look at these voices as a fake light leading you nowhere. To the nowhere, which is also an interesting word because it is now here. the here and now, the moment. That would actually then mean it's leading you to life, because life is in the moment, yeah? But the fake light, certainly not. It's leading you to an afterlife that is the next round through the moon, the white light program. Wherever you are right now, be it on a mobile phone, on a computer, or at a computer actually, you know, because I'm not sitting on the computer, in a library, in a cafe, or at home. Everything around you is dead. Just look around you, yeah? So, the items that you use and so on, usually, even at home, yeah, everything around you is dead. Except for the plants that you have in your home eventually, or pets or something, you know? And you are holding death in your hands. Right now, because everything of reality has had to be destroyed for you to have dead things. It's all living, yeah? The plastic is from the oil that is the blood of earth, living. Living substance. That's why there's a limit into the extraction of this, you know? That's why they have to do these things now. Everything in your home, your kitchen, your laundry, your bedroom, your office of ice, your car, the cover, the suburbs and the cities is dead. What you see as suburb and city substance, not included, you know, the life forms. That is meant with this, you know. There's of course still certain life forms there, but basically, you know, the things that are erected, you know, well, it's just all the dead things, you can see. You are holding death because you enshrine fantasy, soullessness over reality. Enshrine, that means worship. When you have an undefined soul, you do not have to follow a light of somebody else, you know. It's also for the, when you leave your body, it's also what Chiron is pointing out, you have to save your energy for the moment when you leave. That's why it's probably also not good to have a final battle or something, because that really drains your energy. Not only that you lose, you know, that the life force energy will be drained out of your body, you will be leaving in confusion, because you know you are beaten to death and you are on the floor and still they beat you and you are actually already in the process of dying, but they beat it out of you, you know. That's probably also not a good idea, but the slow death with the vaccine is also not a good idea, no? Because then you certainly also don't have the control over this. Yeah. Mm-hmm. When you have an undefined soul, you do not have to follow a light. Because you are the light yourself, you have the light. You have the light connection. Yeah? It's like you would know where your star is. You look out and you see, there's my star. But this you will not know until you leave your body. You know, you cannot figure this out. You can fantasize about it, but very likely not. So, also Chiron said, the white light is everything outside of you. So when you leave your body, you will see a light. You don't go into the light, because you are the light yourself. You stay where you are. Surrounded by darkness, no problem, because look up, the stars are all surrounded by the ether, yeah, the dark matter. They are embedded there, and this is where you stay. And you look around you, and what you see is what you see. And when you decide to incarnate yourself, then you do it, and you don't call Bodas, 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 because then the fisherman is coming with a rescue boat from the moon and brings you back to Earth, you know. and you do it yourself, and then probably you will be not incarnated as a human body, more likely as a tree, because they are the closest to the living creator of do no harm. Yeah, not the animals are not really like this. They are more closer to the human, more like a devil, you know. Like yesterday also with the cat, you know. The third time already she was bringing back the rat. First time, then the second time, I put it downstairs, you know. But okay, she bit off the head already, and then the third time it was only the half of the body, and then right in front of me she was eating this, you know. She enjoyed eating it, and actually she was also offering me to eat, you know. That's why she made first the offer to me. But she was playing around with this, and this was jumping high, and the rat was flying over, you know, the, let's say 10 centimeters high. I had to put up my feet. Oh my god, no, I don't like, you know. But she's doing like this. But at least she was eating then also the corpse of the killed rat, which I don't like. But I know also that the cats, at least sometimes they need to eat also something with substance and not only, you know, the cat food, which is really not good. Maybe also not good for the teeth, like our food also, you know. Yeah, so you don't follow any light. You have your own light. You have to realize, oh, I am the own light. Yeah. So come here, you know. They're calling the white light. Come to the terminal. Come, afterlife. Then they present you the Jesus for the Christian. This is what is happening. You will see the Jesus. Come, come, and you go. And then you are back, born again Christian, you know. Or you see something that you think is Allah, or the Buddha, you see, or the holy cow, whatever. Or you see the Messiah, or whatever they call, you know. And if this doesn't help because you're already off the religions, then what about a loved one? This term loved one is also used many times. This is so fuck shit terms, because love is evil illusion and one is a dead number. You're all dead. Yeah? So there's no loved one, bullshit. But we are talking like this and you cannot say this. Our loved one. So what about a pet like this cat here? That's why it's good when I'm also angry about the cat doing this, you know. Because then I don't love this cat. I'm not into love with the cat. Sometimes good and sometimes get out of here, you know, like this. But she knows this already, and then she only goes away a little bit because she knows danger. But she's waiting until I come, and then yeah, it's okay, you know. And I know also the cat cannot do otherwise. So when this cat appears, I say hello, cat. Because that's actually not the cat, it's just the image of the cat. This is the fantasy. When you're lost in fantasy, you have to unravel this fantasy, all the shit. Because if you have still one fantasy left, you can be drawn in. Not with ease, like with all these others. They will be drawn in like this, easy. But after a while, we wait for you patiently. You will come, you will come. You will feel very lonely, because when you have no soul, you feel lonely, you know, in the space or whatever. Look up in the night sky, you will see this. You just imagine this. Can you be the star up there? And just watch everything. But you have your star. And you can incarnate also, but on your own. Because you can project yourself like Mr. Bean, light beam, you know, and then suddenly Mr. Bean is there. And then already, you know, you are in the life form. They chop it off, no problem. You go up again, use another life form. So you can be always there. Yeah. And you would be always there also. But you choose yourself. You don't follow another light. And that means also not here, this one, yeah? To anywhere. You don't go anywhere. Because you already are the magnificence of the undefined light, that is life, that is truth, that is the star, the sun, the soul, the soul of your living soul. You already are it. But you have forgotten it, and look at this light, you know, it's a nice byproduct, so to speak. And you even forsake it now when you follow. And you hear the others all saying, especially here in Asia, we must follow, yeah. You follow the false light. The living live in dream of life, undefined man. I have a problem with the term dream, because dream is fantasy, yeah. But okay, and the ray is also inside, the ra as well. But this is how he can describe this, you know, because it is still like a movie, you know. The real movie, the real life, you know. So you can call it like this, but I don't know, another word. You hold in focus, and you do not need to follow anything anywhere at any time. You never follow. That's what they don't like. They hate you for this, because you don't follow. You are only one and you're not following. Why you bothered about this one? Yeah, this is a problem. Why it is a problem for you, you know, why you cannot accept? No, you have to leave here. You have to get out. This is really the next step. I see this unfolding. You have to leave the dwelling place, which is in a way correct, because you are not, you don't have to be in a dead place. The air is also not good, you know, when you are inside, just for sleeping or something. But they take this, the necessities, they take it also away from you. That's what I can see. And especially in the situation like I am now, I cannot afford to be somewhere outside without at least gate protection, which is also can be opened easily, you know, in a few seconds, you know, like the SWAT team, they come in easily. But they would have to do this step first, you know what I mean? So there's a little risk, because when they do this, then they have to go through. Yeah, the light that comes for you to follow is fake. There's a light coming for you, the light of another man also. Please follow. Do what we tell you. It's fake. No? Because it is the image of the voice of another man inside your head. Defining heaven, the afterlife, consciousness, ascension, freedom, etc. for you. And all of this is fake, because that voice is just an occultist who is harvesting you. Or it is the occultist in somebody else's head, and he's just doing this as a brainwashed drone. The voices of definitions become the instructions of emotions, directing the actions of the fake persona that we allow to have so much power over our vessels. Yeah. And even for me, yeah? Because every voice that is coming has an influence. It does not matter, it will always resonate, you know. Maintaining the slave status of everyone's vessel. Slave means dependent and serving. Because everyone raised in the system already has someone else inside their head dictating to them. Yeah, and this is a problem, you know, because it's done with the children. That's why you are used to this at least minimum 20 years. And this has so much influence. You're actually done already with 20 years, you know. That's why I needed another 20 years to figure this out. And only because of the internet thing, I could arm myself with as much knowledge as possible, and finally I got to the sources of the most knowledge or the closest to the truth are the Christian love for life and Hironda's works on this channel. And this is what you mainly have to study, you know, maybe some other hints in other directions, but this is actually the main workers, so to speak. No? This is the yoking on boars, so to speak, that you have to study. But it's only the knowledge. You have to unveil the last veil on your own. They cannot bring you to the truth, you know, because they have to do it themselves also. They have to figure out themselves. And you can see how ArtHUR and also Kiran are struggling. Yeah, in these times they're struggling themselves because they are also in the trap, you know. The emotions is the life of the character of another man, the conductor, now inside your head. Put this inside your head. This is also for me, you know, because I have this here all the time when I'm going out. The character is a black magic instrument with K. Yeah. Character. Then when you say character, it sounds already more like, you know, voodoo style. It's of another man, the life force energy of another man, or actually the shadows, the enforced, life enforced shadows of the other man. Work like a conductor, because also Chiron uses the thing about electricity, everything that is, you know, with electricity or electronics has to do with this also, with the system. Now inside your head, constantly offering you the programming, like she said, don't you want I bring you to there, you know, and I help you also to get a passport and, you know, everything in order again. You know, you get the vaccine, then you are one of us and whatever. I don't want to go to hell like you. But they think the opposite. They think that you are actually going to hell because you're going through hell. That's for sure. But only temporarily. You have to go through this painful birth process, so to speak. It's like a birth. Yeah. They say the birth of a new world, but this is not. You are not of the world. This is their world. They can do and die with this, you know. Whatever is coming out of this. That's why it failed also the last time. And it might fail always, you know. I think it's always failing. But they say, this time we make it, you know. Whatever. The orchestra for your vessel to follow along with. And most of the people you see doing this. And that's the interesting thing, to see how this works. And you cannot do anything about it. You have really no power over the others. That's also okay, because you should not have the false light over others. Because it also would be a false light. If you already, what I'm doing here, the influencing, if you follow this, this will not help you. You know, even I give exact instruction how to do this, you will go astray, because you cannot really copy this 100%. It's not possible, because it's not from you. You know, you have to figure out yourself, your unique and original way. You can only see it at most as a guideline, you know. But before this, you have to check everything. Where is the lie? Where is the wrong in this? You know what I mean? Just like those bouncing balls going from word to word in the 1932 musical commercial, I like aeroplane jelly for me. And there's also the YouTube link, you can see it. Yeah, this is what's happening. It's the programming. You have to call it out. You're going along with this. That's why also the offer of karaoke songs. No? Which is, you know, all for the ego, for the self-obsession. I'm a singer, you know. I hear my own voice. It's not your own voice. The voice, yes. Or maybe the voice is... nothing is your own. Everything is not from you. Except for your soul. And even there, you can say, you can still fantasize there is a creator of the soul. That is maybe not you, you know, whatever. But this is hard to explain or to imagine even. The good-hearted 5-year-old little girl singing the song, sitting on a paddy swing entwined with flowers. So that it looks good, you know. I also saw an advertisement yesterday, before one of the videos, and they also said they really teach you the wrong things, you know, about the situation and so on, and we all have to do this together, and everybody will follow. When everybody will follow, then we will progress together. And then I see already the words, you know, like progress for the conspiracy. Yeah, we conspire together. So, and you see the encouragement of the pictures, but the words actually implement already something else. Follow is fall low. You follow, you fall low to another man. That means an outside light, which you are not allowed to do. The religious people are not allowed to do this. They should actually listen to the God, but because they have representatives of the God, this is how they are being hooked. You know what I mean? Instead of saying, wait a minute, when there is a God like this, okay, then I connect to the God with my heart. That means you actually connect to your own, to your star. And then you cannot be controlled, because then you listen to your heart and then you do everything out of your heart and you will sense that's all from the devil. Come on, you know? Yeah. That's why you will certainly have also religious believer that are still in the trap of the fantasy of Jesus and so on, but they actually listen, you know, they do themselves, they don't need a church or something. That's different. Yeah, that they actually also have a chance, theoretically, to make their way out of this. Because even with this going round and round about, you know, my God, that they don't realize actually it's the self-reflection, that they actually still connect to the source. When you are connected to the source, you have then maybe connection to your soul, so to speak. I'm talking in model, yeah? So this is also not real, but I can imagine that they actually get also then the connection, you know? Because you will not sort out all the fantasies, it's not possible. Yeah, it's all fake, and the song she sings as she swings Satan's wings. Sphinx and the Sphinx as well, you know, Egypt, to the subliminal programming of deep hypnosis. Hypnotize the people, yeah? Allows the viewers who follow the ball of this programming so that they can call, they also fall under the spell of the man inside the head. Because when this is repeated, you follow the ball, you see something moving, and then you actually start to sing along with the 5-year-old girl. Yeah? And then you go, and then you are whistling the song. Still going like this. Then you are already under the spell. What a nice spell, you know? And people love it, because this is fantasy, this is a colorful fantasy, not dark yet, not seeing the darkness coming. Instructing them about airplane jelly, where they actually also introduced the airplane, you know, it's coming. As well as those, an airplane is the bird, the wing, you know, that's why the swings. They have to have, as well as those in on the scam, the inventors, the directors and the stockholders and all their administration staff, the manufacturers of the product, the packers, the warehouse staff, the marketers, the truck drivers, the sales reps, the shopkeepers, and the consumers and their children, who are all supporting death because there is nothing real there. And this applies to all advertisements. Yeah? All those involved have grown up to be dead, supporters of death. And you, reading this, are dead too. Yes. This is the so-called last wake-up call. Because otherwise, you would not be on social media. You must be dead. Because that is the dead. And you would not be in the system. You would have left the system already. The system is dead. Because the magnificence of your undefined enduring soul would fulfill you so you would not be reading this. You don't need to read this, yeah, or listen to this. Because you have your soul. This is all you need. Which shows how fallen into the one voice of the eternal hell of a man-made fantasy you really are. And Arthur too, while he's writing this, yeah? Just so we all are. We all are the children in the attic, and back to Helen we go again. If we don't make it out. Now, just this one lie brings in billions of liars supporting the one lie. The one voice ring in the head, the bell, it's also the movie, the bell, to rule them all. Every lie of the system needs a cast of thousands, if not millions, to maintain and support it. When you look at the works of Kieran Last, he emphasizes you have to get off the moon, off the illusion, to see through the illusion, and you do this here, you have to see through the illusion of the system, everything. It's all a lie, the whole world is a lie. But you have to see this also probably in all details, so that you cannot be caught with any form of illusion. That means also a woman is coming to your place, and you're having a fantasy or whatever, you know. Or a man is coming to you, and you're having the fantasy, oh, he can support me, he can spend his money on me or something, you know. He can energize me, he can buy me the dead things that I like, and so on. So when you can see through the illusion here, no matter what they do with your body, you will not go into the light, false light of the moon anymore. Because you then will know also what it is, because you practiced it here already. Everything that you practice here in the moment is also what is happening after. Yeah? You can see the others, they cannot work it out. Even you tell them everything, they will go just in. And then the moon turns red with Saturn and fireball, you know, cleanse everything. The good heart of the little girl is your good heart, but it is fake. So you watch this video clip first, it's very short. Just as the good heart of the little girl is fake. Because she wouldn't be singing the song of fantasy if she realized the significance of what she was doing. Cannot do. That's why the child is being used for this, you know. Hence, or the adult child. Hence the confusion and distractions of fantasy that have misguided this little girl into being a supporter of death to reality. We have to do it a little bit faster. The computer, the cars, the houses, and the education, the degrees, the engineering, the science, etc. that you have grown up with are the fake flowers entwined around the swing of fantasy, and you really are a murderer and you hate life as much as you think you don't. No, I don't hate life. You hate. Otherwise, you would not do all these dead things. Because you love dead fantasy more. Yeah, it's like, I like this woman more than the other. The other woman, yeah, natural beauty, but this one woman, oh my god, so sexy with all the makeup. I love this fantasy more. You will see. Yeah, this is always, usually, you know, like Facebook rating, who's, you know, picture comparison, you will see this artificial more liked. We are all just performing for the conductor of this orchestra of death. All we do this, yeah? The dreamer of this terrible lie that is the system. Raised in the system, this is all you have, and even all the sentiments and good-hearted moral behavior have been, it's only moral behavior as a programming, defined for you, and none of it is really you. That's what the woman here is doing. It's only programming. It's not really from her. From the good heart, she would, all the people would do this, you know, but here's just a programming. If the, and when they change the program, this will happen now, she will do the opposite. That's why I have to be also careful, you know. If the moral basis of your life has been defined to, for you as a program, then it doesn't come naturally from your undefined soul. Because you are mimicking the program of the bouncing ball, be good, be good, be good, of good-hearted sentiments, and it is all fake. Which is why we can never seem to end the war, chaos, sickness and disease, destruction, injustice, cruelty, harm, and all the evidence of annihilation born out of the fantasy to be repeated soon if we do not learn from our misguided ancestors following the bouncing ball or not following anymore. That means religion, occults, esoterics, mythologies, etc. That means also don't follow Kiran Lars, no? That's why he says, unsubscribe from my channel. No? Faster, faster, faster. No time. 10 minutes only. You will see if I made it or not. Because there's no end yet. All the contents of all the libraries and cemeteries. Dog's Latin names. Across earth bear the evidence of all this, but still no one wants to really wake up and stop it. All the people of the cemetery are dead forever, because otherwise, you know, with name, your body has to be put in only into the forest for the animals to eat, and that's it. You don't have to worry and make a party out of this, huh? You're celebrating the death. When you go with the truth, you find that your real friends are very few, because actually no real friends, because also this woman, yeah, just out of the programming. Because those who will roll their sleeves and stand by you are very rare. These are people only they realize harm done to him is harm done to me. And even this, you cannot change it. Like I said already before, you can have billions of people even, it will not help if the other force is coming forcefully and doing things, you know. But this is what we all have to do for each other now. If we are to walk away from this hell hole of our invention and complicity. He's also preparing this for what is going to happen, that they will be removed from land and house. But, yeah, it didn't work. Showing the reality how it is, yeah? There is no one else to blame. If you love fantasy, then you are fully responsible for the outcome or irresponsible in ignorance. This fake patterning program starts from so very young because the sacredness of our parents had already been desecrated, so they desecrated the sacredness of the space they created for us. Just as we desecrate the space for our children by defining them and defining everything of their lives for them, so that they become caught up in all the distractions of the bouncing ball of the system that keep them from focusing on what really matters. The undefined soul of their real lives. That keep them away from focusing on what really matters. He means also keep them away. I put it in, but you will see it's from me with the capital A. Okay, it's no end. Fuck, 3 minutes, I must go. I cannot even read this out in 3 minutes. Fuck, Arthur, this is, you know, what the people then also hate. The emotion come because fuck, it's not going to end. He's not stopping, you know. The addiction to having others tell us how to think and feel and what to do is so strong that most of us remain hooked for the whole of their system lives. Engaging, conning, seducing others, new or otherwise, to instigate their head inside our heads. Creating a mind melt that feeds the need of the addict, who must have someone else constantly in their heads, moving on to a new source when another one drops off, worn out. The whole social fabric of the system, including social media, is this: zombies socializing with zombies to find out which voices in their head suit them most, so they can marry those voices and have children with those voices and educate their children with those voices, so that their children grow up with those voices and then discover other voices that they add to the voices they have grown up with. But where is the undefined soul of no war, no chaos, no destruction, no domination, no harm, no rape, no pillage and plunder, no confusion, no doubt, no or uncertainty or fear, just eternal enduring peace and calm everywhere, with no confusion ever to be encountered and experienced anywhere, because no one wants anything from anyone and no one needs a voice inside the head ever. The undefined soul not only holds the whole dream of life in focus, but sees everything clearly without distortion ever appearing in focus. We need the fix of the voices and often feel panicked, alone, helpless and weak when those who were the voices in our heads shut off their input, which leads us to find a new source of dictating influence to adopt as our thoughts and lifestyle from someone who feeds our fragile ego and nurtures us, giving us a false sense of belonging to the addiction. All the while, they keep us defined and trapped and soulless, no matter the intentions of their good hearts or not. This moving from one fix to the next, one influence to the next, leads to psychotic behavior as our personalities undergo mood swings and extreme changes in direction as we change the voices we listen to. The changing pixelations, the remote flicking channels of the TV, the changing of the pages in a book, trash magazine or newspaper, the endless variety of music, commercial songs and videos being played are all signs of zombies needing distractions because they have no soul. We accept the power of the ticking of the clock, the calendar, going to work, the system rules, the obligations, the emotional bondage of family ties, including Christmas Day, New Year's Day, Easter, birthdays, name days, Saint days, Labor days, Queen's birthday, etc., etc. All of which are definitions of the voices of others that we have been trained to accept. The alphabet languages we are speaking and their mathematics and geometry is just another man inside our heads. When we go to school and university, there is another man inside our heads. And what is the common denominator of this, of all of this? You are allowing the power to go to the maker of this soulless dream just because you fall into a maze of defined dreams that is so vast that it seems limitless does not mean that there is not one power originally, one man, that gains all the power and control over all of man and all of the resources of land, water and food, because you are too confused to notice that you are letting this happen. There's no end. Fuck. Everyone lost to the voices in their heads are lost to the shadow of darkness, fantasy, and all they can do is destroy reality because they are already destroyed. Only the liar can lie, and only the destroyed can destroy, and only the lost and confused can mislead others to be lost and confused too. Through the generations of expanding that fantasy, we are now producing children who are dying before their parents, and over the next few years we will see more and more children dying before they are six, because we are coming to the end of the line of reality. We have become disturbed nature, we worship the disturbance, and as we pass the disturbance down the generations, we are passing on the legacy of destruction of everything of reality, nature, and man's living dream of life, until nothing remains of reality to remind the living who they really are. No end. All the materialism and consumerism, the names of the suburbs and cities you live in, and all the names of all the commercial products for sale that are stacked on shelves or sitting on the floor or in cages, all the infrastructure of the system with its governments, courts and businesses, even the market stalls and the shops, the aeroplanes, the trains and the cars are all the result of voices in your head. None of it is your dream, and the people inside your head defining all this to you don't have your undefined soul in their dreams. Why? Because they need to use and abuse you, because they don't have an undefined soul. And this is what you do to everyone else while you don't have an undefined soul. This voice that you serve and everything that you do for your person is dead and can only create destruction. And everything of your person's character, good or bad, is fake. Social media is the ideal platform for allowing our lives to be constantly under the influence of strangers who know nothing about us and generally speaking do not care who we are or what happens to us. We send the fake kisses and emojis across cyberspace, but where are we when the shit hits the fan in the life of a cyber friend? All the strangers in your head, whether through social media, music, video, TV, internet, advertising media, etc., all bring their issues into your life too. And if you don't sense, know who you really are, they will influence you and you will be at the effect of them. We have all been trained to ignore the magnificence of the undefined soul, so we accept the mediocrity of all those inside our heads who tell us how to think and feel and what to do with our system lives, until we let go of the addictions and create undefined living souls. Nothing of the system will change, and we will all continue to meander down the yellow brick road of definitions, confusion, chaos, all the while kidding ourselves that we are on the path of truth, freedom, consciousness, peace, calm and abundance. No end. Fuck this, you know? You can really start to hate ArtHUR, but that's what it is. when someone tells us what consciousness and truth is, or what it is to be a woman or a man, or a good parent, or what sexy and beautiful is, or who someone else is, and what they are like, and their interests and hobbies, and whether they speak the truth or are a cult, etc., it all comes from the voices in your head. Even when we find out the truth about some of the evils of the system, there are still voices in our heads defining the system of our fake lives for us. When we listen to a song or watch a movie, there are voices inside our heads. When we watch the cricket, go shopping, etc., who we really are is not there. The moment you let a voice in your head is the moment you deny the existence of your lighthouse, and the moment the lighthouse, if you have brought anything of your lighthouse into this life, begins to dim. And all you are left with is disturbed nature destroying reality all around, even as you believe you are doing the right thing and are on the right track. The path to hell is paved with good intentions, and in the system, the road to hell is all about listening to the voices of others inside your head that are the domination of one man over another. Everyone who dies with voices in their heads has been harvested all their lives, and they continue to be harvested by the occultists with their fake dreams of universes where they become gods, peopled with the empty vessels of the men and women they have harvested. Those without a soul have entered into the fantasy dream worlds, and they continue being harvested because without their life energy maintaining the fantasy will fade away. They die in the confusion of all the voices in their head because there is no eternal soul. There is there, and it is all fake, all fantasy. And here we all are in on social media, in the system, dying and destroying the family that we think we love because we are destroying the reality that they are. The point of the voices in your head is to turn you into nothing, to become the flat line of nothing real, because they do not want you to have a soul. Just as all of us do not want those around us to have a soul, in spite of us all saying that we do. You can have all the wealth and jewels of the system, all the armies, military and weapons, all the bureaucracies, all the corporations and control of all the resources, but you have got nothing. Oh, we come to an end. Oh, thanks. I thought this endless. You are just, I make already the ZZZ. Ah. Oh. Save it. Ah. You're just playing power and control trips over others because fantasy is all you have. It is better that they crucify you, chop you up into a thousand pieces and scatter you across earth and kill all your children than to die with a broken will, because that means no more soul. To have someone else inside your head, dominating you, leaving you without a soul, because the undefined soul is all what matters. All that matters. Dark matter. Because matter is actually dark, no? Nothing else does, and until we are creating undefined souls, nothing else we do will get us out of this mess and earth. Out of this mess and earth. Here on last. Nature, reality is no more. Can you find a dream that is not a voice in your head. If you can't, you don't have a soul, and you are just a fake copy of what has been defined for you. The ego. The only way to get out of this mess is to create a living soul, and no one can create a soul for anyone else or be told how to create one. All we can do is to point out how we are trapped and what does not create an undefined living soul, but we can never tell you how to create yours. But I can tell you. And this is what I will also do now. The reason for your life is to create a soul. That is what is also talked about. And you create a soul through live for life, by care for life, care for the life forms, connect to the life forms, to the nature, the flora and the fauna. By using your senses, because this is your soul connection also. Yeah. Using your senses, connecting to that that has life and not the dead things. Don't talk to the dead things, like what I'm doing now. There is no soul. Talk to your cat when you want. Not even talk, just, you know, be with your cat. Use your senses for this. Touch, taste, feel, smell, hear, see. And you practice this. And on the other hand, you see through all the lies, okay, the whole world is a lie, everything, and so on. Don't let anybody rule in your head. Do what you want to do, your will. Yeah. And then, yeah, you eventually have your own soul. This is how you do this. Okay. So, enough now, because I really have to rush. The weather is also good enough to go out. Did you see my emotions already? Because I did not know when is the end, and I was thinking already, maybe I should scroll down, how much is this still, or maybe I'm getting crazy. I had already in my mind that I smashed this computer even, you know. Can you believe how crazy, you know? This is really psychotic. And this is also what happened, you know, with other people when they read, and in Facebook you can see when there's the end, oh my god, so long. And another one, oh my god, so long again. I'm not going to read this, you know, even though it's very valuable information. But now I had to really rush it, otherwise I would have made more comments into this. I saw certain things that I could comment on, but the time is running out, because if not yesterday, but the day before, I actually came a little bit late, so it was not as smooth as before, you know, so that I can treat the cats, because this is more important than this one, you know.